And then maybe the girl, she just might care.
When are we going to put it on?
The end of the show.
Quarter past 7.
Quarter past 7, yeah. So we wouldn't be able to, because it takes up the only machine that plays tape right now. That's the thing. It's machine availability.
So are we on the, we're discussing this on the air, right?
Are we discussing it on the air?
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Yeah, right. We don't have the
tape. That microphone's breaking up. Excuse me.
Hey, Earl?
Earl, the microphone something's happening. Something terrible is happening.
Oh, it's happening and it's terrible.
That was scary, wasn't it?
Oh boy.
But Earl got us out, man. Earl did it again. He saved us from the electricity.
Blind without any earphones.
Right. Fascinating. Hey, listen, we can't...
Have they let you back on the air yet, man?
Well, not officially. I went to the programming meeting. I was invited to the programming meeting the other day by Les Thompson. Carter.
All right, Boss Hitbound.
Right.
Hi, lots of fun being a radio disc jockey.
Sure is,
I have to do that every time he plays that, because I'm a rat.
Hey, listen, do my thighs look interesting to you kids?
Why?
Now look, what were we discussing?
We're discussing the fact that we cannot play the album this week because we will not have tape machine availability because...
Unless we forgot to do the church.
No, don't.
Dear friends!
That was nice.
Well, what time is it? Why don't we play it right now?
Well, now it's 7:05.
No, we wouldn't make it. It's too long.
We could barely get in the first time.
Let's play some excerpts for the friends.
Shall we play one excerpt?
Let's play an excerpt. Oh, sure.
From the promo,
nice.
Then. We'll play the two promos, and next week we'll give them
the whole
thing.
It takes 20 listenings through anyway. I don't think we're blowing
just
anything
little,
by playing
no,
the excerpt
no, not at
discs.
All.
All right.
Want to hear a section of it?
After all, it's 5.
Yeah, well, thank you, Larry. Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Charlie.
Hi, I'm Les. Oh, no, this isn't the right music.
The wrong one.
I'll go back.
The Fireside Theater Radio Hour is on the air. And anything else they can get their hands on.
Right.
Car.
Burn. Is that a 45?
Yeah.
45, guys.
45. Why don't you just segue into it up on the air?
Let's talk about your car. It's screaming, wash me, please. Now, if you're Mr. Common Sense, you won't believe me when I tell you that I've got an envelope that'll clean your car while you're driving at home to work. Well, George, believe me, this time, because this one isn't like the Austrian self-sharpening razors. No, friends, no overheating like with the tropical fishes. No zizzing and dripping like with the dike.
Come on now, fellas, let's tell him how it hurts. Let's tell him how it hurts. And then maybe the girl, she just might care.
When are we going to put it on?
The end of the show.
Quarter past 7.
Quarter past 7, yeah. So we wouldn't be able to, because it takes up the only machine that plays tape right now. That's the thing. It's machine availability.
So are we on the... we're discussing this on the air, right?
Are we discussing it on the air?
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Yeah, right. We don't have the
tape. That microphone's breaking up. Excuse me.
Hey, Earl?
Earl, the microphone is... Something's happening. Something terrible is happening.
Oh, it's happening and it's terrible.
That was scary, wasn't it?
Oh boy.
But Earl got us out, man. Earl did it again. He saved us from the electricity.
Blind without any earphones.
Right.
Fascinating.
Hey, listen, we can't...
Have they let you back on the air yet, man?
Well, not officially. I went to the programming meeting. I was invited to the programming meeting the other day by Les Thompson. Carter.
All right, Boss Hitbound.
Right.
Hi, lots of fun being a radio disc jockey.
Sure is, Les.
I have to do that every time he plays that, because I'm a rat.
Hey, listen, do my thighs look interesting to you kids?
Why?
What were we discussing?
We were discussing the fact that we cannot play the album this week because we will not have tape machine availability because...
Unless we forgot to do the church.
No, don't.
Dear friends!
That was nice.
Well, what time is it? Why don't we play it right now?
Well, right now it's 7:05.
No, we wouldn't make it. It's too long.
We could barely get in the first time.
Let's play some excerpts for the friends.
Shall we play one excerpt?
Let's play an excerpt. Oh, sure.
From the promo,
nice.
Then. We'll play the two promos, and next week we'll
give
them the
whole
thing. Listen,
it takes 20 listenings through anyway. I don't think we're blowing anything by playing the excerpt discs.
Want to hear a section of it?
After all, it's 5.
Thank you, Larry. Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Charlie.
Hi, I'm Les. Oh, no, this isn't the right music.
The wrong one.
I'll go back.
The Fireside Theater Radio Hour is on the air. And anything else they can get their hands on.
Right.
Oh.
questions out of 45?
Yeah.
45, guys.
Why don't you just segue into it up on the air?
Let's talk about your car. It's screaming, wash me, please. Now, if you're Mr. Common Sense, you won't believe me when I tell you that I've got an envelope that'll clean your car while you're driving at home to work. Well, George, believe me, this time, because this one isn't like the Austrian self-sharpening razors. No, friends, no overheating like with the tropical fishes. No zizzing and dripping like with the...
I am 36 years old and have had dysentery since 1955. It has been diagnosed once as being amoebic dysentery. It recurs frequently after indiscretion in diet. After evacuation, there is a weakness, more so in the legs, as one may feel after a long journey, but in that case, of course, the legs feel stiff, while in my case, besides a sense of tiredness, the legs feel loosened, resulting in depression throughout the body. It disappears after an hour or so, or more quickly if any work involving physical strain is undertaken. I also suffer from ringworm.
Oh, that's terrible.
However, I do have a wonderful, wonderful, in this Illustrated Weekly of India, there is just a lovely limerick. These was an old lady of Herm, who tied bows on the tail of a worm. She said, you look festive. You'll wriggle them off if you squirm.
That sounds a lot better in Hindi.
Yes, I imagine so. There's something
in Hindi,
wrong
that's when
there.
You hide it and never tell it at all.
Also, I got, as part of my membership in the World Press Association club, the Borneo Bulletin of March 14th, 1970 in the
very
mail.
Very rare one, you know.
Just like to read you one of the interesting articles in the Borneo Bulletin here. Fat ducks stolen. Sibu. Madam Lee C. Moi of Pedai Lane off Nanang Road found 6 ducks stolen while she went to feed them on the morning of March 5th. Each duck was fat and over 6 pounds in weight, she said. 3 small ones were left in the hut. It's the sort of thing that's going on in Borneo.
You mean that you can't take your fat ducks to Borneo if you happen to be a fat duck star,
no,
for example, and expect any kind of privacy?
Oh, no.
Not at all. Forget it.
In camouflaging a very large bust, the neckline of the frock is extremely important. A high neck should be avoided as it exposes and emphasizes the opulent contours of the bust. A V-neck, on the other hand, is excellent as it cuts both breadth and roundness. Slip-on sweaters are NG, but you can wear a cardigan if you do not button it. Gracefully cut revers of moderate size.
George, please, would you go on?
The woman with an undeveloped bust should, in the main, adopt tactics opposite to those just described. However, for her as well, the high neckline is out, since it does nothing...
We'll use the other take, George. George, let's try that again. Try this one with the flag flying over the low neckline.
Instrumental. Somebody who closes her letter, Yours in Christ, followed by a signature that appears to be Urdu, but on closer examination is Catherine Chang, written backwards. Once at least 4 girls, aged 16 to 19, to help her to form an instrumental pop group. Non-players will be considered if they are willing to be taught. The address is The Heatles, Box 72, Kuala Belait, Brunei, Borneo.
Borneo!
He had shown her his etchings and poured her another martini. Tell me, he said, do you object to making love?
That's something I've never done.
Never made love?
How silly can you be?
I wish I had enough money to buy an elephant.
Why do you want an elephant?
I don't. I just wish I had the money.
The breasts are supported on the feminine body by various muscles and ligaments. Some of these muscles reach upward and fasten on the collarbone. Others fan outward to the chest. The health and elasticity of these supporting muscles, Tonto, has much to do with the shape and firmness of the breasts. Yes, Tonto, the manner in which you exercise and the skill with which you select your bra will determine the health and elasticity of these supporting muscles, assuming the tissues are not already destroyed beyond repair. Yes, Tonto, breasts reach their normal state of development after
you
puberty.
You never talk about breasts before.
What suddenly happened in your head?
What was in that cigarette?
Wait a minute.
Your period of stresses and strain will come to an end, and you will be able to enter social and group activities confidently.
Take a bite of this silver bullet.
When I catch a pin.
Your breasts are definitely tied with your general physical health and makeup.
My breasts are tied!
Your weight, your height, your type of contour, etc.
Buying a flask.
Yes, Tonto, I've known breathtakingly beautiful women who use dime store face powders and lip rouges. Not because they can't afford to spend 10 or 100 times as much, but because they found their shades that are best suited to them.
Try these shades on, Tonto, and then I think we can get out of this box canyon.
A policeman walking at dusk besides the Tatau River. Fourth Division. Saw a movement in the bushes.
Look out for that orchestra.
Took a shot, searched in vain for inquiry, and went home. Next day, the Twi Ruma of a nearby longhouse reported the loss of a cow. When the police went to investigate, a cow, enraged by a bullet in an eye, charged them without warning. The man who had put it there fired again and killed it. He paid compensation to the Twi Ruma, took the carcass, and sold the meat. He made a profit on it, too.
Well, you know, Tonto, it stands to reason that a brassiere made of sturdier material will give better figure control than one made of more fragile stuff.
Right on, Kimasabi!
The American flag flies high tonight over the breasts of American womanhood!
Valhalla is coming to Southern California. This is Remington Noble aboard the flagship of a great Viking armada sailing for Southern California. Mighty Norsemen strain at their oars, muscles rippling beneath their fierce horned helmets, proudly transporting the first Valhalla Thunderbolt petroleum products to the American West. And California motorists will soon sample the fuel of the gods. Valhalla Thunderbolt Gasoline, a product of Viking research and engineering. Look for Valhalla Thunderbolt Gasoline soon, beneath the sign of the Prancing Norseman. Valhalla above all. Put a Thunderbolt in your tank.
Wonderful, wonderful to be with you again.
What?
I have earlier referred to Charles Chester during the rubber slump when I was on leave and Charles was working as a hall porter. I had terrible dysentery coupled with my own slump, you know.
Before you sit down in there, would you help me port this hall over here?
He said he had 2 days leave to spend with me and would like to have some tennis, a game I did not like. Was my dysentery.
Quite so.
But I agreed.
Slumping is very bad for your tennis, right?
As,
over the hump in the
as he bought his flannels in a racket, and I said I would come to watch him play. After he had a game or two and flirted with some of the girls, we returned to my furnished house at Bourne End. On the way home, I decided to buy some of my favorite Chopin records and a Victor Sylvester. We entered a music shop. The manager was standing talking to some earnest young men in spectacles with long hair, no doubt musicians, but there was a young lady who smilingly came over to service. I explained my requirements, and she went to a large cupboard, picked the dance record out of the top drawer, then bent down to the bottom drawer for the Chopin's. She's wearing a very tight skirt, which emphasized a rather large but shapely bottom. Charles just could not resist the temptation to give her a tap on the bottom. However, he tapped a bit harder with his racket than he meant to, and she toppled forward and bumped her head. Chester, like lightning, slipped out of the door in his sneakers, noiselessly and unseen. The girl with a red face and disheveled hair got up, turned round, and before I could move, slapped me on the face as hard as she could and called me every nasty name she could think of, in fact, losing control of herself.
You piece of cheese!
you non-traditional musician!
The manager turned at me and said, "How dare you!" before turning to the young lady, wringing his hands and repeating, "Miss Wilson, Miss Wilson." I made a beeline for the door, leaving my Chopins on the floor.
Oh, wonderful. That's from the Borneo Bulletin?
That's called As I Recall, and the Borneo Bulletin.
Well, you know, Tonto, no other organ of the female anatomy can be so easily injured.
Who is that man?
Such injuries may often turn out to be permanent. If you wish to massage your breasts, Sheriff, do it gently and slowly. Avoid vigorous and too frequent use of this practice. Should you wish to massage, do so at night and for no more than a period of 10 minutes. Always rub around and around and up. Never should you push your breasts down or flatten them. To do so might very easily weaken the muscles supporting them and tend to stretch the tissues.